A lot of people are aware that there's a connection between music and math, how to read notes and the value of notes and all the fractional values involved, but also in the abstract thinking that goes into the process of creating a song. The math helps you up to a certain point, and then the creativity takes over. And when you blend those two things together, you get a very powerful combination of good music. I graduated college in 1974 and started teaching in LA City schools. After 5 years of teaching, I discovered that all I was doing was repair work with kids. Probably the most frustrating thing for teachers is to realize that you've got kids that are working 1, 2, 3, sometimes 4 years below grade level by the time they get to middle school. My son Nick was born in January of 1980. Over the first few years of his life, everything he did seemed to be involved in some form of creativity. And as he got a little bit older, it became really obvious that he had a very analytical mind. I had the opportunity to discuss math ideas that were way beyond his years. And so I had to come up with ways to speak with him about these things that made sense to him. And that was when I started changing the language. So many of the things that Nick and I have done in our past have led to Mathnasium's corporate mission statement, which is to teach children math in a way that makes sense to them. I mean, Nick and I created thousands of pages of math curriculum. He and I were always incredibly close together, working collaboratively on everything that we did. I don't think I ever yelled at him once. On May 7th, 1999, Nick was working for our family electronics business, and I paid him, and he went out. He had a date that night. A few minutes before 5, the next morning, the phone rang. It was a call from a nurse at County General Hospital, and she said, I think you better get down here. Nick had fallen asleep at the wheel, coming home very late from a date. And as every teenage driver knows, you shouldn't drive when you're tired. But he did a solo car spin out in front of County General Hospital, and he passed that day. My wife and I sat down, and we said, so, where do we go from here? We found this Buddha statue, and it's the Buddha releasing a fish back into the river. This is kind of our release of all the goings on with our son's passing. With Nick not being here, probably the greatest memorial that we can do is to make this work that was based on his thinking to indeed bring it to a larger audience. It was 3 years later that I met Peter and Dave and we started Mathnasium. We're literally worldwide now. There are Mathnasiums on every continent but Africa and Australia. The first trip I took for Mathnasium was we opened our first international center. Spent a week doing interviews and training staff, all kinds of things. And when I was ready to leave, my host there gave me a present, this picture. And when I looked at it, I said, you have no idea how important this is to me and my wife. And this was the universe bringing the fish back in multiplicity. And the number of adults and the number of kids whose lives have been touched by Nick's presence and all the people we've touched with the Mathnasium method.